I started in 1981 with the Canada Cup back at the Northlands Coliseum, as this building facility was called then. I was working for a radio and TV station in Edmonton, and the fellow that that assisted the regular PA announcer left and relocated elsewhere in Canada, and I thought, this is the perfect opportunity. So I called the Oilers and I spoke to a former communications director by the name of Bill Torelli, and I said, I'm available. He said, good, we need someone for the Canada Cup. Can you pronounce Russian and Czechoslovakian and Polish? And I said, you bet. Couldn't. But, you know, once you're in the door. I'm here a couple hours before, you know, for 7 o'clock game. I'm usually here 5 o'clock. I'll go into the media lounge, have dinner, usually sit with Rod Phillips. Bob Stauffer. We'll just chat about hockey. It's all very casual. I'll go over the names that I'm not familiar with in terms of pronouncing them with Rod Phillips. And if there's still some doubt, I'll wander up to the Bill Tuohy press box, the catwalk, and seek out the visiting team broadcasters and get the proper pronunciation. I'll go through all the game night scripts, even though they remain very much the same from game to game. But I'll go through them, read through them, make sure there are no surprises. If there are any errors, and there seldom are errors, you know, I'll catch them. Because they all come out of a hard drive and they're automatically printed off. And what may be pertinent to the last home game may not be irrelevant to the home game tonight. And stuff like that happens, so it's just being prepared. Well, I made a mistake back in the 80s, which saw me score a goal in the National Hockey League by mistake. Messier had scored a goal one night. I can't even remember who the Oilers were playing, but I wrote my name down on the stat sheet that I keep. These sheets here, it's just a very simple sheet for goals, assists, and penalties, and I wrote my name down on it, turned the microphone on. The Oilers' goal, his 47th of the season, scored by number 11, Mark Lewis. And then I thought, wow, if you're going to make a mistake, you may as well make a classic. One of the best seats in the house. You get to meet, you know, an awful lot of the people that make decisions affecting how a hockey team performs and plays, the executive. Occasionally you get to meet a player, and that's nice, but it's just really interesting that you can come and watch sport at its highest level. And you get to understand not so much how the game is played on the ice, but you get to understand simply by exposure to, you know, a lot of the executive, a lot of the coaches, as to why things are done. And there are reasons why a player either plays here or does not. And you can really appreciate the business side of hockey. If you can put your emotions aside, if you're disappointed over the home team either tying or losing, there's still a terrific entertainment value in what you're seeing on the ice. So park your emotions, and you can come away thoroughly entertained game after game.